No, he's first been over to Memphis on several occasions. They're working to the hospital.
Good morning. I'm Robin Chapin. I'm the executive director of Second Harvest Food Bank of Northeast Tennessee. We are part of the Feeding America Network, the nation's largest domestic hunger relief organization, working to connect people with food and ending hunger. Donors, staff, and volunteers all play an important role in our efforts to end hunger in the United States. We recognize that people who access the Feeding America Network are making trade-offs between buying food and covering the other basic needs such as housing and health costs. In order to address food insecurity, we must think about it as one factor dependent on a matrix of other factors that are inhibiting sustained stability among clients. This requires us to engage in a systematic way in our community if we are able to achieve a large-scale social change. So thank you so much, and again, welcome, and I'm going to turn it over to Kathleen.
What I want to do is just welcome you and hope that by the end of this day you're inspired and want and see yourself at this table, because it's taking all different folks. What I'm just looking at around each of these tables, and it is amusing because it's all across sectors. It's all, it takes government, it takes nonprofits, farmers, you name it, it's gonna take that to make us all healthier. So I'm really excited that y'all are here. And now I'm gonna turn over to Andrew from Rural Support Market.
So my job here today is just to get us pointed in the right direction and try to keep us on track. Again, my name is Andrew Crosson. My organization is Rural Support Partners. We play an interesting role in the region. We manage a lot of partnerships between different types of organizations that are working to be more effective at rural development. And so we support collaboration between nonprofits, government agencies, funders, the private sector, all manner of organizations and actors. And I've got to say that this group, both the group that convened this conference and the folks here in the room, are one of the most diverse and multi-sector groups that I've seen in this work. It really is impressive, and it really speaks to the value and the broad-ranging importance of the issues that we're here to talk about today. We've got a lot of different roles represented here today. We've got academia in the room. We've got funders. We've got government agencies from the federal to the state to the local level, which is just fantastic. We've got nonprofit organizations, faith groups, community groups, the healthcare sector represented here. And what we've all got in common is that we have a stake in our community health, in healthy food systems, in healthy local economies, and in healthy people. And we all have a role to play there as well. So what we're here to do, the first thing we're here to do is just to understand how it all fits together, see the big picture, to see the intersections between agriculture, public health, nutrition, economic development. The second objective is about connecting with each other. The folks who are doing this work, as Rhonda said, none of it can be done without connecting to the other people doing similar work. Our work has to add up to more than the sum of its parts, and that means we've got to know each other, we've got to make connections, we've got to build relationships. So there's going to be time for us to do that here today as well, and I encourage you to do so. And lastly, we want to understand what we're all doing and where we need to be working together more. Okay, so we can all be better at what we're doing, we can work harder, we can be more effective, but there are some things that just take bigger strategies. So where can we do more from our own seats, and where are we going to need something bigger, bolder, more collaborative to really move the needle and make the difference that we're trying to make? This work emerged out of a regional food and ag systems working group. This working group, as Kathleen said, was a combination between two existing networks that have been operating in the region for some time. First is the Central Appalachian Network, or CAN. This is a network that's been around since the early 90s. It's a group of nonprofit organizations, economic development practitioners that have been working together across Central Appalachia. There's currently 7 member organizations covering 5 states from Ohio down to eastern Tennessee. Appalachian Sustainable Development, ASD, is the local member based in Abingdon but serving eastern Tennessee as well. And what this group does is they support peer learning across not just the member organizations, but a much broader network of networks, nonprofits, community groups, other economic development practitioners. They support peer learning. They support sector-focused strategies through working groups and other things in sectors like forestry, food systems, energy, entrepreneurship, things like that. And they support regional collaboration. So when a strategy needs to be bigger than just one county or one state or one organization, it's hard to make that happen. That's one of the roles that CAN plays, is to help to weave that together, support regional collaboration, support collaborative fundraising, things like that. The other network is the Appalachia Funders Network. It hasn't been around quite as long, about 5 or 6 years. It currently has over 80 different grant makers involved. And these are grant makers of all sizes and types, from federal agencies down to grassroots community foundations and everything in between, national foundations, regional foundations, banks, individual philanthropists. What they all have in common is that they're all investing in Appalachia to create a more prosperous and sustainable region. They do that through developing shared analysis. They have working groups where they work to develop collaborative strategies, and they work to align their investments. So all of their grants and investments, helping them see how they can fit together to add up, again, to greater impact. These two groups came together about 4 years ago because they recognized the potential value of having funders and practitioners talking to each other outside of the normal grant maker grantee relationship, right? So rather than just having a grant application and a report, they realized they wanted to better understand the issues that they were both working on from their different seats. And so they formed this joint food systems working group where they could actually do some learning together as partners and as colleagues, where they could co-design strategies together and where they could implement those strategies together and learn throughout the process. They primarily did that through a USDA Rural Community Development Initiative grant, RCDI for short. This grant is to support capacity building in local food systems. And we targeted four different subregions across Appalachia, and one of those subregions was Northeast Tennessee and Southwest Virginia. So that's how this group got its start.